Now we would like to start the establishment of the joint venture on HVDC business between Hitachi and ABB. Today we have with us Mr. Hiroaki Nakanishi, the chairman and CEO of Hitachi Limited, and also Mr. Ulrich Spielhofer, CEO of ABB. Before we start, we would like to have a photo session. So those of you who have cameras, please proceed towards the front.
それでは続きまして、日立中西よりご挨拶。
Now, Mr. Nakanishi from Hitachi will give an opening remark. Thank you very much for coming to this press conference between Hitachi and ABB. I really appreciate this very big turnout. And the announcement today is that Hitachi Limited and ABB, targeting the Japanese domestic market, will be providing high voltage direct current business in Japan, and that we are going to establish a joint venture. So I would like to explain to you about the fact that we have reached a basic agreement. Now, the establishment of the joint venture is expected to be established in April of next year. And as you know, the electricity sector in Japan is going through a lot of changes, and very efficient technology to connect the different grids is the HVDC technology. So the strength of both of the companies will be provided through this joint venture. The new company will be providing HVDC to the Japanese customers. And we will do the engineering work, manufacturing, as well as after services will be provided. And for us, this is going to be a very important step. And between Hitachi and ABB, we would use this step to move forward with a more extensive collaboration in the future. Now, let me first talk to you about the domestic market. As I said earlier, if we look at the electricity grid situation in Japan, we are thinking about how to separate generation, transmission, and distribution. And this, when we have unstable renewable energy, we have to think about how we can operate our grid more effectively. So there are some new needs that have come into this sector. So we believe that HVDC is going to change dramatically to the VSC system around the world. And for HVDC that connects the grid, we, Hitachi, have been participating in 9 of the projects using LCC. So in terms of working with the technology, we feel comfortable. Now, with regard to ABB, there are engaged in 14 out of 15 HVDC projects around the world, and ABB has a long tradition and expertise in this area of HVDC. So they have a very strong technological background. So our system capability of Hitachi and ABB's HVDC technology can be utilized so that we can provide a highly efficient HVDC system in Japan. That is the purpose of our joint venture. In social innovation business, we have been involved in various system approach in the businesses. However, as I said earlier, for HVDC, we have the VSC as well as LCC systems. The type that we have been provided are LCC type. So we have the ability to transform AC to DC, DC to AC, and ABB's high technology is needed. And we want to provide this in a very stable manner to the Japanese market.
So that is our big target and objective. And therefore, the gentleman who is standing next to me, Mr. Ulrich Spiesshofer, and myself have been having a long discussion. With his leadership, we are able to establish this joint venture. So that is why we are making this announcement today. This partnership will be developed in the future so that we can enjoy a win-win situation, a new environment for us. So I would like to ask you for your continuous support and cooperation. That concludes my opening remarks. Thank you. Next.
We would like to invite Mr. Schlichthofer, CEO of ABB.
Konnichiwa.
Hello, everybody. Thank you very much for coming.
Today is a fantastic day for ABB, for Hitachi, for Japan. Together, Hitachi and ABB will be in an ideal position to bring our new combined HVDC value proposition to Japanese power grid customers. ABB is proud of having served customers in Japan for more than 100 years with our local presence. We operate in 13 cities in the country with our own operations and two joint ventures that we have established already previously. Our activities are in sales, in service, and we have a local manufacturing footprint. We assemble, for example, control systems for power generation, as well as robotics components here in Japan. New opportunities have come up recently. The focus on renewable energy has led to good domestic growth in the solar sector for ABB, while the separation of generation and transmission and distribution markets, the so-called unbundling, will make the market even more accessible. Orders received for us in this country have exceeded 600 billion yen and have grown about 10% annually in the last years. What is the agreement between Hitachi and ABB about? Sustainable power for tomorrow's Japan. Hitachi and ABB, two friendly partners of complementary strengths, have today concluded and signed a memorandum of understanding on the establishment of a joint venture for power grid technology, HVDC, or high voltage direct current. We are aiming to establish the joint venture in the next few months, subject to the completion of all legal and other contractual aspects. I'm very, very pleased that with Hitachi, we have been able to join forces with such a strong partner, an acknowledged global and national expert in its field for this agreement. Our planned joint venture represents an exciting step for both our companies, and I very much look forward to have continuous work together in the future on this project. It is a personal honor for me to conclude this agreement with my friend, Hiroaki Nakanishi, who has been an outstanding leader for Hitachi for many years and has done remarkable work to reorganize and reposition his company in recent years. The new entity, which will be based here in Tokyo, will be responsible for the design, engineering, supply, and after-sales services related to DC systems of HVDC projects. It will bring ABB's latest technologies to the Japanese market for projects in which Hitachi will be the prime contractor. The shareholding ratios in the new company will be Hitachi 51% and ABB 49%. The company will be a subsidiary of Hitachi. The overseeing entity of the joint venture from Hitachi's side will be the Energy Solutions Business Management Division. If we look at the market to respond to the changing market, Hitachi and ABB will strengthen and expand the HVDC business by establishing a new company that combines both companies' strengths to create a framework for providing new technologies to Japanese customers in a timely manner. The Japanese market, since the 1970s, there are 6 sites, 9 HVDC projects. The 9 projects have been completed so far since 1970, have all been line commuted converter systems, or we call it HVDC Classic. However, with the growing adoption of renewable energy and electric power systems, and given space constraint issues, the demand for new technology, voltage source conversion, we call it VSC, HVDC systems, ABB's HVDC light technology is an ideal solution to reinforce existing grids and for underground and subsea applications. The global market is in the order of 400 to 600 billion yen annually, and the local market is of significant size as well. Since the 1970s, most HVDC projects have used HVDC classic systems. However, in the past decade, there is increasing demand for HVDC light technology based on the push for integrating renewables and transmission of electricity across long distances with minimum losses. In addition to grid reinforcement and significantly reduced right-of-way requirements, this technology is ideal for underground and subsea applications used in interconnections between islands, offshore wind connections, shore supply, as well as connections into cities. ABB brings significant value to this new partnership. As a pioneer and world leader in this field, with an unmatched track record for more than half a century in HVDC and more than 100 years in power technologies, ABB will contribute to the development of Japan's sustainable electric power infrastructure and push on the integration of renewables by bringing state-of-the-art HVDC technologies, domain expertise, engineering skills, and global experience to the joint venture. ABB pioneered HVDC technology more than 60 years ago and has been awarded close to 100 HVDC projects, representing a total installed capacity of more than 120,000 megawatts, accounting for about half of the world's installed base. ABB's HVDC light solution leads the way in voltage source conversion, and our company has delivered 14 of the 15 globally commissioned links in the world. This year, ABB launched, in addition, a revolutionary new technology, the world's most powerful cable for underground and underwater projects and power links at 525,000 volts. So if we look into the future, we expect that the Japanese HVDC market to expand, driven by the changes in market environment, such as the increased focus on renewable energy in the evolving energy mix, and upgrade and strengthening of the overall electricity and power infrastructure. We expect to see an increase in the number of HVDC light projects for utilities, as the increase in renewable energy and renewal of the electric power system requires the strengthening of wide area connections and the connection of offshore wind farms. So in summary, together, Hitachi and ABB will be ideally positioned to build a stronger, smarter, and more flexible power grid for Japan. Domo arigato.
Now we would like to entertain questions.
The staff will bring your microphone, so please state your name and affiliation before you ask your question. Any questions? The person in the middle, please.
Tabeta from the Nippon Keizai Shimbun.
So you are establishing a joint venture of HVDC business, and Mr. Nakanishi earlier said that you are thinking about further expanding this collaboration. What are some of the areas? Is it going to be the general transmission distribution area, or are you thinking of different areas other than Japan, for example, in Asia as well as other parts of Japan? This is the first question. Before I directly answer your question, we have a social innovation business, and including electricity, we are providing solutions to the global area as a business. And that is the major assumption before this. So if we deploy our business in this way, then to try to develop all of the components in-house is not feasible in the first place. ABB has a long history, and they have various equipments that are deployed worldwide, and that can be utilized. I think that is quite compatible with what we do. Now, with regard to HVDC, the system is now changing from LCC to VSC, and with the additional renewable energy, there are other applications simply not connecting the grids. There are new applications. Therefore, this is the reason why we focus on this point first. So there are other complementary relationship with respect to other components, so I can expect more in the future. But I don't think we are in a position to tell you about the future. However, we will try to be addressing this in a very flexible manner to create this partnership relationship. I will be mentioning into Ulrich, and if Ulrich says it's a good idea, then we believe that it is going to be quite promising in the future.
To what my friend Nakanishi-san already laid out. Today, a new child is born, HVDC partnership between Hitachi and ABB. And we have agreed that we first let the child learn to walk and do the first steps and go in the right direction. And maybe there will be other elements where we can work together in the future. We want to first prove the point in a good partnership and get significant progress going. And naturally, if you look at large companies like Hitachi and ABB, there could be many more ideas of joint activities. And when the time is right, we will focus on them. Today, the focus is on the HVDC partnership for Japan.
Does
this answer your question? We have you said you spent a very long time discussing this matter, but this discussion that culminated in this joint venture, how long did it take? About 1 year, or when did this discussion start to have this day today? Well, for HVDC, we've been discussing this for over a year. Over 1 year. HVDC, as I mentioned earlier, is technologically advanced. It's very sophisticated. Two grids are connected. It is very difficult to have synchronized. And therefore, this is a very difficult technology. So we were exploring what method is ideal. And so our method, our strength, and the technology ABB has have been discussed so that we can have a best matching. So that is why we had this discussion for over a year. ABB's superior technology. We have to understand this well. And ABB needs to understand the intent we have for the system. And so this type of communication will be required going forward. Lastly, GE is now having a joint venture of the Alstom's transmission and distribution business. So there is this consolidation going on throughout the world. Hitachi and ABB, in this wave of consolidation, you will work as a group to compete with other rival manufacturers. Is this the position of the joint venture? What is your thinking? I will not say yes or no to that question today, but we are going to think of many options. We need to think of many things, especially T&D, transmission and distribution demand. Renewables is increasing, and urbanization is progressing. So the social structure is different from the conventional power system, and this change is taking throughout the world. And so we need to tackle these new business opportunities. There are many opportunities. So GE and Alstom has formed this format in T&D. It's not as simple as we just competing with them. It's not as simple as that.
From my side for your question. Number one, ABB is the global market leader in transmission and distribution, and we have a firm aspiration to stay in that position. We are the biggest spender on R&D annually, globally, and that has allowed us to pioneer many new technologies. 1954, we brought out HVDC. In the last decades, we brought out HVDC Light. This year, we have launched a new revolutionary cable system that allows us to transport double the amount of any other competitor over longer distances. So we have a very strong technology business position. We have established a strong global service network and a local presence all around the world. In certain segments around the world, it makes a lot of sense to partner up and bring two complementary strengths together. And that's what we're doing here with a focused joint venture on the Japanese market, where we have found a good way to work together. And I'm particularly proud the last quarters, the last year when we worked on this opportunity, it was done in the spirit of customer orientation. It was done in the spirit of friendship and complementary strengths. And that's a very, very good seed into a future healthy relationship. Now the global competitive landscape is changing all the time. One thing that you can count on in the future, ABB will be there and will be number one.
Any other questions? Center towards the back, please. My name is Kobayashi from TV Tokyo. I have a question to Mr. Ulrich. So in this HVDC business, you have a good track record on the global basis. But in Japan, you are working with Hitachi. You will establish a joint venture with Hitachi to pursue this business. Japanese electric power companies, there is a high hurdle for EPCs to import the technology from overseas, and that is why you are working with Hitachi? Is that why you made this decision?
Look, to serve a customer in the right way, you need a couple of different ingredients to bake a good cake and serve that to the customers. First, you need to understand the local requirements, the specifics, the topology of the existing grid, the specific requirements. And if I look at the Japanese power grid, it's the most reliable in the world. If you look at the uptime, the reliability of the power grid today, it's already very strong. So that is something where a local player has significant intimacy and understanding of the local requirements. Then secondly, when you want to build successful these projects, it's important to bring not only technology, but also execution experience. Hitachi has a very strong track record of providing construction and installation projects on time with good accuracy and very, very strong capabilities. And that's the reason why we, when we looked at the Japanese market, felt quite proud to have such a strong partner working with us on this activity here. The third point is you need to make sure that you have people that are accustomed with the local way of doing business. And again, whilst we have a strong activity here in Japan already, here we have some complementary strengths. And doing business in Japan in joint ventures, and by the way, in many other markets of the world, is natural to ABB. Today, we have already a turbocharger joint venture here in Japan. We have another joint venture on power plant control systems, which are both very successful businesses. So this is now the third joint venture of ABB in Japan. And I'm sure with that combination, we will not only continue to write a more than 100-year history of ABB in the future, but we will turn the page and really have a new partner for a very long time, because this is not a short-term oriented activity. This is an activity that we are planning jointly for a very long foreseeable future.
Any other questions, please? The person in the front, in the middle, please. My name is Shikita from Nikkan Kogyo Shimbun. I'd like to confirm the process that has taken place. Which company tried to address the other? Was it Hitachi or was it ABB? As far as HVDC is concerned, it was Hitachi who actually approached ABB. So in carrying out your business, you thought that there was something lacking, you needed something to complement? Yes, with respect to HVDC, VSC bulb, we thought that ABB's technology is something that we need to leverage. That's the starting point. So was it Mr. Nakanishi who actually led it, or was it Mr. Higashihara? Well, I've had a long relationship with ABB, not only on specific subjects such as this, but I have a regular communication with Ulrich. And ABB is a very interesting company. Hitachi. Well, people say that we have become a global company, but we are not that global as ABB. When we first met, he told me something that is very impressive. In order to join my executive committee, you don't need a passport. You just be able to speak a broken English. It's a Swiss company. The headquarters is in Switzerland, and he said so. So I thought it was very interesting. I thought that there were many things that I can learn from this company. That was my first impression. And from there on, we communicated in many ways, and we ultimately ended up with this HVDC project. Was that about 10 years ago? It's actually 4 years ago. Thank you. And as an EPC manufacturer, if you can procure ABB's products, then you need not have established the joint venture. But looking at the situation, you may be maybe giving up the Japanese market. Maybe that's another way of looking at things. In establishing a joint venture, were there any opposition within the management? No, there weren't at all. Trying to do everything in-house is not an attractive way of doing business at all. It's very inefficient, and we should bring our strengths together and to provide something better for the customer with a solid technology, with a good delivery date and quality is very important, and that is where we find the highest value. Therefore, we were not reluctant at all about joint venture. Now, what about the turnover? What kind of target turnover do you have? Now, Japan is a domestic market, so the market itself is not very large. Even if you try very hard, it will be about 2 billion, 1 billion per year. So in a sense, Mr. Ulrich said that the child would start working, but this is just a first step.
So your phase two will be, I don't know, this is something we need to study going forward. Are you going abroad? Well, that is possible. Or you will widen the scope of the collaboration. For example, this time it's just a transmission business, but a substation or distribution. Are you going to expand the T&D? Yes, ABB is strong in automation. So there's possibility for various types of collaboration, like FA, yes. FA, then your plants, your factories, you will maybe install some kind of equipment. No, we will do business together. Now, not just T&D, but in many business domain, you may have a chance for opportunity for the collaboration. Well, not only ABB, but I understand the strength of this partnership with ABB very well, so. So that's what we're going to focus on. Thank you.
To what you, to your questions from our perspective, what Hiraki laid out, I fully agree with. At the time when we came together for the first communication and first discussion, Hitachi was searching, ABB was looking, and that's a great situation to be in. So both parties were open, and the interests were highly complementary. There is a world out there which is challenging in terms of the overall economic climate. In these kind of times, you need to very, very carefully consider how you allocate your capital, how you prioritize your activities, and what you will do yourself and what you will do with partners. As you have seen in the announcement of our next level strategy on September 9 this year, we have clearly articulated that partnerships will be one element of driving organic profitable growth in ABB in the future. And I'm really, really very happy and proud that we are able today to yet announce another partnership in the jigsaw puzzle of the future ABB that really makes us a stronger partner, but not only by taking benefit for us, but as Hiraki laid out, creating a win-win situation in a very specific and clearly defined market opportunity, which I think is a great way of starting a long-term product partnership.
じゃあそちらの一番前の角の方お願いします。
The person in the front, in the corner, please.
The Swiss magazine Finance and Wirtschaft. I have a question about the market for your products. There is the liberalization of the electricity market in Japan, that is true. But this government likes nuclear power very much. They're not really interested in renewable energy. The electricity companies love their monopolies, and they're not really interested in connecting their monopoly areas with a better grid. So what is your judgment of the market for this new transmission technology? I would like to ask both of you.
まずあの日本の今のグリッド
Now, if you look at the Japanese grids, in comparison to the rest of the world, you see a regional monopoly. And you are right in saying that. However, that is not going to be that way. About 3.5 years ago, in September, after September 11 of 2011, the change has taken place, and it just happened that there was a major earthquake. Of course, that had the trigger. However, in parallel to that, the renewable energy such as solar and wind energy developed very much, and this had forced the wide area operation of the distribution and transmission. So what I would like to tell you is that there was a natural disaster. You have to look at the economic trend as well as global warming, climate change, all of these factors are no longer allowing in the electric utilities in Japan to enjoy monopoly. And the government, the utility companies, and the consumers have come to share this common understanding. However, in order to make adjustments, there are policy decisions that are to be made. And it may, yes, and it has taken time. But you have to look at the nationwide grid situation and the HVDC technology can be applied in many ways. That is how we see it. And that had been a trigger. And HVDC is just an example. For example, in the case of renewable energy, these are renewable and it's unstable. And there are all sorts of things that are needed to stabilize. Or else, even if we encourage to do solar power generation, we cannot actually connect the grid. So there's another technology called STATCOM. So I think we have to apply many things. That is the current situation. And the Japanese market is such that it is one of the most exciting market in the world.
A couple of thoughts. First of all, when you're in the power grid business, and ABB is in this business since more than 100 years, you don't train for sprints, you train for marathon runs. Because changing the power grid infrastructure in any country in any significant way, it is a long-term journey that needs to start at a certain point. Number two that I wanted to share with you, if you look at the trend globally on renewables, in 20 years' time, 40% of the global installed capacity on power generation side will be renewables. And grid parity and attractiveness of the commercial value proposition of renewables is changing every day to the positive. So there's very clearly a long distance perspective where it plays a very strong role. Today already, HVDC technology can help a lot. One element is the feed-in of renewables into the grid, but it's only one of the elements. The other element is the grid reliability. You have in Japan, in the one part of the country, a 60 hertz grid, on the other part of the country, you have a 50 hertz grid. Making sure you can connect this in an even better way and go across the different frequencies in a good, low loss economic way is not a benefit of the HVDC technology. Connecting islands out there, bringing them in any kind of power supply is an important element. So if you look, there are enough building stones for a successful HVDC business today. We start this journey today. We will have some successes in the next years and we look forward to them. But we are definitely looking forward to build a very long-term business that so goes the change in Japan. So will we be positioned. We will not get nervous about this. We will not question the viability. This is a long-term direction where we already have a good start ahead of ourselves short-term.
Okay.
Any other questions? This gentleman, please. My name is Kobayashi from NHK. It is related to your previous question. 4 years later, the separation of the generation and transmission will start. So I have a question on that. How do you plan to expand this business opportunity? You said that 1 to 2 billion yen a year, this is the revenue to begin with. How do you expect to grow this going forward? To both of you, please. So separation of transmission, power generation, transmission, distribution. We do not know what this will look like because we need more discussion. From manufacturer's standpoint, it is difficult to project or predict. However, as a technology trend, this regional monopoly will dissolve. That is for sure. So the connection between the 9 utilities, how will this develop? The separation between generation and transmission is separating the business, dividing the business, but getting rid of this monopoly. This is an organic connection of the grid. It is a very technical issue. So the solution, the answer for that is something we have to come up with, and this will lead to our business opportunity. What kind of management operation this will be, we do not know, but we think we can start discussing these technology beforehand. Now, as a trend, this distributed power source is something we cannot avoid. So we need to deal with this. And this separation of generation transmission, it's not just about the system. There are many business opportunities in front of us, not just the system. So this HVDC joint venture is the theme today. But going ahead, we can expect big changes. And that is why we are deciding to form a partnership to move this forward. So that is the background. I have another question. I'm sorry I will digress, but Chairman Nakanishi, you had the labor management management and Prime Minister Abe asked for another salary raise again. So what is your thinking behind this? Oh, well, this is different from today's theme, so difficult to comment on that. But Abenomics, based on the recent election, how will Abenomics turn out? As a company, we would like to support this as much as possible, but in what way? What to do next spring regarding salary? We have not decided. The salary level, pay level, this is decided between the negotiation between the management and labor. So I cannot say make commitments today. Our HR department will scold me if I make any commitments today. So let me refrain from saying anything more.
Any other questions, please? Are there any other questions? Yes, the person towards the left in the middle, please. Ihara from Nihon Keizai Shimbun. The first question. From the growth strategy of your company, how do you look at this alliance from the operating profit ratio and so forth? Is it going to be part of the global top companies? So how would this alliance contribute to your companies? Can you just try to organize this answer? As I said earlier, Hitachi, in 2010, we took a new start, a change from recovery to a new growth. So that key business would be social innovation business. We are not simply providing equipments, but we will provide control and IT. So we can provide more rational and efficient system. And that was the declaration we made. And the solution that we provide can be widened with the collaboration with ABB. Therefore, HVDC market itself is not very large. However, in an overall strategy, this is one of the important elements of our strategy. And earlier, Ulrich said that part of the jigsaw puzzle of ABB was created. And we feel exactly the same. Hitachi has a big jigsaw puzzle. And next year, it's going to be the last year of our medium-term plan. And when we think of the next step, I believe that this is a very important step forward. So in my mind, it has a very significant meaning from the business perspective. And in 2015, we will be coming up with a medium-term plan targeting 2018, and which will be announced. So at that time,
one of the this partnership is going to have a meaning there. I would like to ask you one more question.
ABB perspective on this one. I think we are highly complementary here. Our situation is the following. Last year, after I was announced CEO of ABB, we did a simple exercise in ABB. We called it the heat map. We basically looked all across the world of our markets and said, where are we already strong today? And where could we have opportunities that we should focus on going forward? And Japan is definitely a market where ABB has a 100-year history, very good, but we could do much more in the future. Now, what we also have done then is that, okay, how do we go after these opportunities that we have? And we have defined in our next level strategy clearly three ways of growing the company in the future. The one is driving organic growth through penetrating existing markets already stronger. The second one is doing mergers and acquisitions. And the third one, and that's a new one in our new strategy, going stronger for partnerships. And in Japan, it's very clear, for the reasons that I laid out before, that we would benefit very strongly from combining our own capabilities with a partner's capabilities. So as one of the forceful actions in implementing our new strategy, we are announcing today the partnership with Hitachi, which is right in the middle of the center of the next couple of years' activities that we have. So we said in September what we will do, and today we are doing what we said.
Another question, which is a more casual question. The background of this alliance, I think, has the relationship, personal relationship between the two gentlemen. So not just business, but maybe you are very close in professional and private terms. On what kind of occasion did you start associating with each other? On a personal note. Well, chemistry. Yes, we do have chemistry between ourselves. Good chemistry. But with Mr. Ulrich, it's only been 1.5 years, a year and a half. His predecessor, Joe Hogan, since his days, we had connections. And as I said earlier, the way we think of our thinking is open and transparent. And we pursue diversification. And this strengthens the company's capability. If you, it's not a company culture where you try to force and control the company. So the very important element, when we think of partnership, it is easy to think of you as a candidate. It's not one strong person saying, everyone come under me. I force everything. Of course, there's technical confidentiality, of course, but we are very frank and free, and we can discuss the next step on a market-oriented basis. And so that was why we were able to realize this.
I think we both join a passion for customers. So when we started talking, and I remember well one of the early events where when we were both in Shanghai, we are both on the Mayor of Shanghai Advisory Committee. We met there and took some time to think a bit about the future. We realized what brings us together is a strong customer focus and thinking how can we provide customer value. The second piece is, if you look at ABB's history in the last decade, we have done about 40 acquisitions. We have done many joint ventures, and we have learned a lot of good lessons there. One lesson is there needs to be a high cultural fit between the companies, but also the leaders that are involved there. And we found very quickly, we established a couple of ground rules and said we will be totally transparent and open with each other and make sure that we have the common customer value in the focus. So it's not good enough to have complementary strengths in terms of technology, which we have. It's not good enough to have complementary strengths in terms of regional positioning, which we have. But the third piece, and it's good that you mentioned that, is really the cultural fit on institutional, and on individual level. And in our case, I would say that's fully the case.
Oh, thank you.
Next, the person in the front, please. Nannichi from Asahi newspaper. I would like to ask you about the management of the new company. That's my first question. And in establishing the joint venture, you talked about the liberalization of the utilities as well as the separation of the distribution and transmission and so forth. So what kind of roles would the management people will serve? As to the management, we are going to select four executives. ABB and Hitachi will provide two people each. And the chairman and CEO would be from Hitachi, and president and COO will come from ABB. That is what we have in mind right now. The impact to the power utilities in Japan would be such that Hitachi should be the contact point. There are many Japanese utilities have outstanding engineers, and their requirements, in a way, sometimes become a bottleneck. So by fully understanding them, we need to proceed with our projects. So Hitachi is going to serve as an initiative in that area. And when this company is going to provide VSC, HVDC, and power electronics will be applied, and we would provide engineering service as well as the products. That is what we have in mind right now.
So in Japan, the liberalization of electricity, whether the separation of generation and transmission will succeed, whether the price will go down, this is another theme. But the benefit to the users, benefit to the clients, customers, benefit to the general public. By establishing this company, do you think this will progress more benefit to the users? Will this be realized? Well, we can have a wider selection of technology, wider option. So we think this is positive, and I want you to think this is positive. However, with this, this will not solve all political matters. I cannot say that. And it's not something a manufacturer can say.
I think it's very important. If you look at a power grid, you want to have reliable power supply. You want to have low losses, and you want to have attractive customer prices. With the value proposition, the joint value proposition, we are able to transport and distribute power with less losses. The reliability of the building blocks of the new offering is proven. As I've said before, we have basically half of the global installed base, and on the new HVDC light technology, we have done 14 of the 15 commissioned projects. So there is a proven good technology that will enhance reliability, efficiency, and cost attractiveness of the grid. So together, we provide something to the Japanese customer which should be highly attractive.
Any other questions,
please? Yes, the person in the middle, please. I'm sorry for asking a very technical question, but in the case of VSC, in comparison to LCC, how much less loss do you experience? And how efficient is VSC compared to LCC? And I'd like to know how advantageous VSC is in comparison to LCC. And so how great is HVDC compared to ordinary AC? And how efficient can you be depending on the distance? I'm sorry for asking this very basic question.
We answer these questions because he is basically the godfather from a business perspective in my team. for this activity.
Yeah, sure. So first of all, the comparison between the HVDC technology and the HVAC, and there is a clear advantage in terms of ability to transfer bulk power long distances. DC basically reduces the losses almost to a zero, as opposed to transmitting AC power, which is then, of course, above 300 to 400 kilometers, it starts to be not competitive anymore. Then when it comes to comparing the HVDC classic or the LCC technology, comparing that to the VSC technology or what we call HVDC light, there is one clear advantage, which is the footprint and therefore the cost competitiveness on that side. HVDC light or VSC applications, they reach up to roughly 2,000 megawatt worth of power transmitted, as opposed to the classic, to the thyristor base. There we actually, ABB is implementing solutions on the ultra high voltage, where we can reach up to 10,000 megawatt worth of power. And therefore, there is a different application in that sense. But when it comes to the between a few hundred megawatt to 2,000 megawatt, clearly the HVDC light technology has advantages in terms of footprint, cost competitiveness, and also a much more flexible way of managing the grid by being able to provide flexible power both on the active side as well as on the reactive side.
Particularly, the Japanese HVDC is such that when it first started, it was connecting 50 and 60 in the SACMAs. The frequency changer was the first start. And we used the ASEA's equipment. ASEA was a parent company of ABB in the past. And at that time, 50 and 60 were different frequencies, and they were operating independently. Therefore, there is a valve to synchronize on one hand and on the other hand. In other words, they could only look at their own frequency, and this was connected with AC, and by using DC, it's going to become LCC. With this combination, it will work with LCC. However, if you want to connect a totally different grid, and if it's DC in between, then you will have to synchronize the frequency, and that is VSC. From the system's perspective, VSC is more flexible from the systematic standpoint. However, there are some difficulties. In other words, you have to look at the outside and to try to adjust, and you do the frequency excitation. I believe that in the future, it's going to be all VSC.
In simple terms, you could say the HVDC Classic and the HVDC Light together allow us to play the grand piano of different situations and play the right tune for whatever situation that you're in. When you're in a situation where it's lower power, you play the HVDC Light tune. And if you have longer distance, very high voltage transmission, it's HVDC Classic. Combined, if you look between Hitachi and ABB, we have a wonderful offering now to give the customer the choice.
Any other questions? A person at the front, please. Chairman Nakanishi, I would like to ask you a question on a different theme. Italy, the railway business in Italy, you made a proposal to acquire this business. The counterpart, if soon, they said they want to come to a conclusion by the end of this year at the earliest. What is the progress? How do you think this, what is your prospect or the progress? Any hint you could provide us? We have no new news today, nothing we can share with you today. So I don't have any new information today. But if you're asking me for bottleneck, no, I have not heard of any bottlenecks. So, the counterpart, they're taking time to do due diligence? Is that what they're doing now? Well, this started as a political matter in the Italian operation, North and South. There's two plants, factory. And the efficiency is completely different. And so we made a proposal that that should be improved. So I don't know what they are scrutinizing or looking into right now. I don't know. So that's why I cannot say anything more. The labor union, are they a bottleneck? Well, that's always the case. It's Italy. I see. Thank you.
So the time has come. So with this, we'd like to close this press conference. Thank you very much.